Hi everyone, this is Matt with 2A Direct, and today we're going to go over programming a CP200 to be matched up with a Vertex VX231. So first step we're going to do here is go ahead and open up your commercial series programming software, the CPS, and make sure you've plugged in your USB cable and gone through the appropriate steps to install the drivers. And make sure your radio is powered on and the cable is plugged into the side of the radio, and go ahead and hit the read button. And you'll see a progress indicator, and all the information is going to populate up on the screen here. And we're going to go down to the conventional personalities because this is what we're going to need to add into those 231 radios. So you can either cut and paste these or jot them down on a pad of paper. So what we're going to focus on here is the receive and transmit frequencies. So in this circumstance, channel 1, we're going to go ahead and write down that the transmit and receive are a 465.5. And then we also need to write down another important piece of information, which is the squelch type here. So we can see that it's a TPL that's been selected because the DPL here is grayed out, so go ahead and ignore that. And then it's a TPL, and we look down here, and it's 107.2. And it matches on the other side. So go ahead and write that down for channel 1. And then we'll go down to channel 2 here, and it's 467.86 for the transmit and receive. So you're going to go ahead and jot that down, and then notice here that in this circumstance a DPL is selected. The TPL now is grayed out. So we have a 567 DPL for the second channel here. And last channel 3 on the CP200, we have a 451.25 for the transmit and receive. And then we can see here a TPL has been selected, so go ahead and jot down the 229.1. One other thing to note on this radio is it has not been narrowbanded. So a quick touch on that. In order to narrowband your CP200, we're going to go over to the channel bandwidth and the kilohertz spacing here, and go ahead and select 12.5 for personalities 3, 2, and 1. And then go ahead and write that back into the radio so that it meets the FCC regulations of narrowbanding. So now that you've written down the frequencies and narrowbanded your CP200, and go down to the VX230. So go ahead and plug in your USB cable for the 231 and make sure that you've installed the drivers and that you've gone up and configured which COM port that that's set to. And then go ahead and you're going to read the 231. So click on the arrow here facing the computer screen. If you highlight over it, it'll give you a preview. So we know that one is read. And now we're going to go ahead and follow the instructions. So switch the radio on and off, and you'll see the programming indicator and read complete. So now we're just going to go down the line here and alter this archive to be matched up with the CP200. Now on the CP200, we saw that it was only a three-channel radio, so we're going to go ahead and deactivate these remaining channels by just double-clicking on the side here. And as I do that, you can see that that information becomes grayed out. And now we have the three channels here. So then you're going to go ahead and type in those frequencies that we pulled off of the CP200. So as you can see already, the 231's already come narrowbanded. I can't even change this to wideband if I double-click in there. So that step's already been accomplished for you. And then you're going to go ahead and type in the frequency information in each of these columns. So you're going to go ahead and type in that happened to be the same frequency. And over here, you'll notice that Vertex calls these sub-audio tones, which were the DPL and TPL on the CP200. If I could maybe pull up a side-by-side of these to show you guys that really quick. So as we can see here, so again, sub-audio tone on the 231, Motorola here calls it a squelch type and a TPL. So what you can do, if you jotted those down, or we can just do a Control C and copy this frequency, and then we're going to go ahead and move that over to the 231. So we have this one pulled up side by side. So then we'll go ahead and click in the receive column here and go ahead and paste that in. And you can see it's automatically copied that over to the transmit side. And then a side-by-side comparison, we have that TPL of 107.2. And we need to go ahead and click over here in the first column. And you can see that this is set to a DPL right now. Vertex calls it a DCS code. So we need to change that to the other type of tone. So go ahead and hit the space bar. And one more time. And that's going to auto-populate in the CTCSS. So now from here, we're going to go ahead and select that 107.2, or the TPL as Motorola refers to it. So that channel's all matched up. So we're going to go ahead and check personality 2 over here, which is a 467.86 again. So go ahead and type that in. Just hit the tab button. It's going to auto-populate that on the transmit side. And then we can see here that there's a DPL, as Motorola calls it, of a 567. So go ahead and hit the space bar once, and then one more time, and double-click within that field and select 567. So you can see, going down the line here, that one's not available in the chart here. So what we're going to have to do on the Vertex is manually type that in. So go ahead and just hit OK for now. And then within that field, just start typing a D-567, and it'll allow you to manually type that in there. So good workaround. If it doesn't show up in the chart there, you can always manually type it in. And last channel here is channel 3. So we have a 451.25. So typing that in and hitting tab is going to auto-populate that onto the transmit side. And now we have one of those TPLs again, so click that first column over there. And we're going to hit the space bar once. And if you double-click in there, we'll see if that one shows up within the chart. And it looks like that one is not in there, so we're going to have to do a manual entry once again. Or we can select it here. All right, so we have those three channels filled out. And if we just go back and double check everything, we can see that everything matches up on that channel. Personality 2. Just always do a quick once over to make sure everything's apples for apples. And personality 1. So now that we see everything matches on the 231, we can go ahead and write this information back into the radio. So what we're going to go ahead and do is at the top of the screen here is click on the icon with the red arrow facing the radio and go ahead and click yes here and then follow the prompts. And it's going to say reading, but then it's going to write all that information that you've edited back into the radio. So that process is complete. Now you can put the two radios side by side and go ahead and hit the push to talk button on both radios and make sure that they are synced up on all three channels, and everything should be good to go. And that's programming again, pulling information off of a CP200 and manually entering it into a 231 to make these two radios communicate with one another. And 2-Way Direct will be back again soon with another programming video for you. Thank you very much.